Today, we are here to talk about an attack on our communities, an attack on our families, and an attack on our public health. This attack will disproportionately be felt in low-income communities, whether they be rural or urban, many of them communities of color, who just don't have the resources to just pack up and move away from the pollution. These communities don't have the wealth, the resources, the connections, in some cases the complexion, to rein in the big oil and gas industries, to protect themselves. And I'll tell you what, they will be targeted. These communities will carry a disproportionate share and burden of the pollution that happens as a result of the legislation and coordinated attack that is before us. Yes, these communities will be enticed with jobs, but often these are jobs that are low-paying jobs, and that will further expose them to risk. Listen, we're not anti-jobs, as Leanne mentioned. We are not anti-economic development, but we are against the expansion of dirty industries running free at the expense of the public health and quality of life of a vast majority of our residents, many of them who have no other option. And I'll tell you what we are for. We are for the benefits of clean fuel, public transportation, and access to good-paying jobs that are clean jobs and aren't hazardous to our health. We are for clean, green communities that aren't dumped on. We are for lower asthma and cancer rates. We are for green schools for our children and access to fresh, quality food. Look, I'm not kidding. I'm not fooling anybody here. I'm a city girl. I didn't grow up on a farm or in a wild preserve. I don't even have a membership to the Sierra Club. But I'm not new. Well, I might be a little new to this conversation, a little new to the environment conversation. But what I'm not new to is fighting for justice, fighting for my people and for my family and for my neighbors. And what I learned in the last couple of months that I've been here with my colleague, Representative Kruger Banneke, is very simple. The environment is not just about trees and forests and rivers and streams. The environment is where we live, where we work, where we play. The environment is our communities, our homes, our churches, our schools. So when we talk about legislation that will allow just a few legislators to block or delay important measures that will keep our communities healthy and safe, I'm ready to fight. When we talk about legislation that will block measures that will promote public health, that will keep our air and our water clean, we are talking about an attack on our homes. We are talking about an attack on our communities, an attack on our environment, and I am ready to fight. So I stand with my colleagues today, and I stand with the advocates today to say that we will not sit by as you attack us. We will not sit by as you attack our environment, as you attack our communities. We will stand with our neighbors. We will stand with our friends. We will stand with our children. And we will arm our communities with the education and the resources they need to advocate and launch a counterattack. And trust me, we will not go down easily. This series of legislation will not pass without a fight. Thank you for your time.